What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the StackMob plugin in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Managing a Minecraft server can be challenging, since players can cause lag by a various amount of in-game activities. One of these is having too many entities at a single location, causing gameplay-related problems for all of the players. Solving mob lag could involve lots of technical work, leading some people to search for something simple. Luckily, Minecraft 1.16 and above servers can implement the StackMob plugin to reduce lag. Using this forces mobs into a single stack, meaning you can have hundreds of mobs that only appear as one. It's an extremely useful plugin that lowers stress on your server, so let's go over how to set it up. Head to StackMob on Spigot and press Download Now, and then save this file somewhere easily accessible for later. Head towards your Apex server panel and click FTP file access near the top left, log in, and then enter the plugins directory, and then you can select Upload near the top left corner. On the next page, you can drag and drop the plugins file into the upload area, and then wait for it to reach 100%. Once that's done, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. Next, just join and use the /plugins command to confirm that the plugin was installed. Once you jump into the game, there should be some noticeable changes. For instance, some or all of your entities will be stacked, but that isn't always the case due to the plugin's default settings in the configuration. The configuration carries most of the plugin's features. These range from setting the max stack size to disabling specific mobs from stacking. Head into your FTP file access, log in, and head towards the plugins directory, and then you can find and select the StackMob folder, and then press Edit to the right-hand side of the config file. In this file, you can make any changes to the plugin settings, and afterwards click Save at the top and return to the server panel. From here, you can restart the server and join the game to confirm it worked, or you can just use the /sm reload command in-game to apply the changes. Here is a suggested setting setup, which you can try to see if it works or if you want to adjust certain features. An alternative method for stacking mobs is setting custom parameters for desired entities inside of the config file. You can find these settings at the bottom, and once it's set up, it'll override the default value and only apply to that entity. Instead of waiting around for mobs to stack, you can also use the stacking tool. This is only obtainable through the SM tool command, which is for admins or players with authorized access. It works by right-clicking the entity, but you'll need to set a mode first by shift right-clicking. There are 6 modes to choose from: slice, slice all, remove single, remove chunk, info, and modify. They are mainly self-explanatory, as slicing a stacked mob will withdraw one from the stack. The best type to use is modify, allowing you to manually change the mob's amount. There aren't too many commands to use in-game, but each of them are important for managing the plugin. For example, after making changes to some settings, using the reload function will apply them without having to do a server restart. Others include forcefully stacking mobs, spawning stacked entities, and other helpful commands. Players aren't going to have access to these by default, but becoming a server operator will change that, or you can use a permissions plugin like Luck Perms to grant players certain permissions. If you install the plugin and it doesn't work, double check your server's version or type. It needs to be a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot, and you'll also want to make sure that your server version matches the version of the plugin you downloaded. When making config changes, make sure to save the file and either restart the server or use SM reload in game. If you do this and the changes aren't saving, this could be due to using the incorrect format or value for a setting. A popular issue is using capitalization or missing spaces for options, so double check your formatting and try again. Whether your players have created a mob farm that has gotten too big, or if you just want to reduce mob lag as much as possible, this plugin is a great way to do it. And with how easy it is to set up, you'll be playing in no time. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.